If you hadn't noticed, I'm a knight.
Hello, I'm Knight Jake, host of the Amati Fortress Radio Podcast.
Hello and welcome to Knight Jake Speaks. I'm your host, Knight Jake. Welcome to part 3 on our series on a brief history of Lutheranism in Queensland, also known as the State of Division. In part A, we witnessed the early days of Lutheranism in Queensland, from 1838 through to 1900. In part B, we witnessed the building up of the largest union in Australian Lutheran history, the 1966 Union of the Evangelical Lutheran Church of Australia, also known as the ELCA, and the United Evangelical Lutheran Church in Australia, also known as the UELCA, to form the Lutheran Church of Australia, also known as the LCA. And now in this video, part C, we will witness the side effects and downfall of the 1966 Union. From the 1830s through to the 1960s, the Lutheran synods of Australia continually drew closer together until 1966, when the Lutheran churches of Australia all united into one synod, the Lutheran Church of Australia, also known as the LCA. But already in 1966, divisions began among the Lutherans. The LCA had been formed from the UELCA and the ELCA. Many members of the ELCA, however, opposed the union. Thus, in 1966, when the LCA formed, a collection of congregations refused the union and formed the Evangelical Lutheran Congregations of the Reformation, also known as the ELCRA. Between the 1960s to the 1990s, the LCA would remain relatively united. As for the ELCRA, between the 1960s and the 1990s, the ELCRA would experience 4 significant splits. The first split took place in 1971. In 1966, the ELCRA joined in fellowship with the Lutheran Churches of the Reformation, or LCR, in the United States of America. Since Pastor Frederick Kleinig, the founding and sole pastor of ELCRA, was elderly and in need of assistance, the LCR sent Pastor Keith Hunter to Australia in 1967. However, a conflict arose between Pastor Kleinig and Pastor Hunter concerning the practice of head coverings during the public worship. The ELCRA believed that Christian women had a moral command to wear head coverings during worship. This led to Pastor Hunter and 40 members to sever fellowship with the ELCRA in 1971. Pastor Hunter's group was an independent Lutheran parish known as the Faith Lutheran Parish. This division between Pastor Kleinig and Pastor Hunter also led to the breaking of fellowship between the ELCRA and the LCR in America. The second major split in the ELCRA took place in 1973. The ELCRA was still in need of more pastors. In 1971, the ELCRA called a lay missionary, Audley Grieger, from the Aboriginal mission at Cooper Pedy, South Australia. Audley Grieger became a vicar of the ELCR and continued his studies for the office of the ministry. In 1972, Bryce Winter also began his studies for the ministry. And in 1973, issues arose over the dress of women and the length of men's hair. The ELCRA cracked down on these issues, but Vicar Grieger accused the ELCRA of legalism and left the synod to form his own synod, the Orthodox Evangelical Lutheran Church, also known as the OELC. At this point, Vicar Grieger became Pastor Grieger of the OELC. Now, before we discuss the third major division of the ELCRA, we need to follow Pastor Hunter and the Faith Lutheran Parish. In 1971, Pastor Hunter broke away from the ELCRA and formed the Faith Lutheran Parish. Pastor Hunter had a difficult service, made worse by lack of finances and bouts of ill health. In 1977, Pastor Hunter resigned from the ministry in Australia and returned to his homeland of the United States of America. The flock was dismayed and without a shepherd, and the road ahead seemed bleak, but soon faith would be saved via an independent Lutheran congregation in South Australia. In 1973, Pastor Thomas Dudley began a conservative Lutheran mission in Adelaide, South Australia. Pastor Dudley was the pastor of Grace Independent Lutheran Church in Hillsborough, Oregon, a congregation which had left the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod and sought fellowship with the Wisconsin Evangelical Lutheran Synod. Dr. Schoenauer was a member of this church. Dr. Schoenauer had received an appointment at the University of Adelaide, and after moving to Adelaide, South Australia, Dr. Schoenauer and his family wished to retain membership with the Grace Lutheran Church in Hillsborough. Dr. Schoenauer had originally left the Missouri Synod over issues with liberalism, and he could see the same fate for the Lutheran Church of Australia. Dr. Schoenauer had written a letter detailing the liberalism in the Lutheran Seminary in Adelaide. That was the seminary of the Lutheran Church of Australia. He circulated his letter amongst the LCA congregations and received a powerful backlash. However, Norm Fitzner and his family in Keith, South Australia, responded favourably to the letter, and in 1975 they sought membership with Grace Lutheran Church, Hillsborough. In 1977, Pastor Dudley began to make visits to South Australia, establishing a conservative Lutheran mission to the region. By this time, Pastor Dudley was ministering to a group of about 8 people in Adelaide, Narracourt and Keith, South Australia. But the influence of his mission spread to concerned members of the LCA in Victoria and New South Wales. It was thus decided to form the Federation of Conservative Lutherans. Fears arose in the LCA that a Lutheran splinter group was forming in the South Australian region. Reports of Pastor Dudley's work spread to the Faith Lutheran Parish in Queensland. Pastor Hunter had been approached by Norm Fitzner concerning fellowship. Pastor Hunter had had no interest in fellowship. But now that Pastor Hunter had left for America, the Faith Lutheran Parish saw a glimmer of hope in Pastor Dudley and the Federation of Conservative Lutherans. Pastor Dudley had been ministering to his Australian members via recorded services from 1977 to 1983. The members of the Faith Lutheran Parish would be sustained by these tapes, with the laymen performing baptisms, Holy Communion, confirmations, and weddings. In 1978, an official congregation was established at Narracourt, South Australia. The congregation was called Grace Lutheran Church, Australia, and was considered an extension of the Grace Lutheran Church in Hillsborough, and all the members of Grace Australia were considered members of Hillsborough. In 1981, Grace Australia would purchase some land at Elizabeth, a suburb of Adelaide. Pastor Dudley would continue to visit Australia to serve Grace at Elizabeth and to visit the members at Keith, South Australia, and also some other members at Hamilton, Victoria. The two member congregations of the Faith Lutheran Parish, Our Redeemer, Brisbane, and St. Paul's, Maryborough, saw the Grace Lutheran Church as a sister congregation, and in 1979, Faith and Grace declared fellowship with one another. Pastor Dudley attempted to colloquize a pastor from the LCA to serve Faith. However, failing this, he would approach the Wisconsin Evangelical Lutheran Synod and the Evangelical Lutheran Synod, also in America, which were in fellowship with one another. Thus, in 1984, Pastor Bill Mack of the Elves would come and serve in Australia. In 1986, Faith would lose all financial support from Grace Lutheran Church, Hillsborough, when Hillsborough decided to cease their mission in Australia. In 1987, Pastor Mack would return to America, and in 1988, Faith would receive the Wells pastor, Dan Schroeder, to come and serve them. Under Pastor Schroeder's leadership, Faith would become organized into an official synod, adopting the name the Evangelical Lutheran Synod of Australia, also known as ELSA. Not to be confused with Pastor Fritz's ELSA, which was later renamed ELCA in 1944. As for the new ELSA, they would officially be incorporated in 1992. As of 1991, the ELSA retained connection with the Grace Lutheran Church in South Australia, which had dwindled to a handful of members in Narracourt, South Australia. These members would join the ELSA and become Prince of Peace Lutheran Church. The ELSA, who was in fellowship with the Wells and Ells Synods in America, would be served mainly by vicars from these two synods. Now as for the third division of the ELCRA, this took place in 1983 over a dispute regarding the use of a Catholic campsite by the ELCRA youth for a camp. One group opposed the use of a campsite, declaring that it was church fellowship with the Catholics. The ELCRA held firm and rejected such a view. The dissenting group of about 30 people left the ELCRA. Among them was the ELCRA's founder, Pastor Frederick Kleinig, who had been retired for the past 8 years. This small group, which I am referring to as the Kleinig Group, lasted only a very short time. Pastor Kleinig was their sole pastor and had been retired for 8 years. He would pass away in 1987 and the group would fizzle away into nothingness. Now at this point in time, I'd like to step back from the English-speaking Lutheran churches in Queensland and to give an update on the Latvians and the Danish Lutherans in Australia. We'll start first with the Latvians. As stated in Part B, in 1951, two separate Latvian Lutheran groups had formed in Brisbane. The Brisbane Latvian Evangelical Lutheran Congregation and the Brisbane Latvian Evangelical Lutheran Mara Congregation. Now, on November 21st, 1987, these two groups amalgamated to form the Queensland Latvian Evangelical Lutheran Congregation and became the Queensland branch of the Latvian Evangelical Lutheran Church Abroad. The Latvian churches in Australia are in official fellowship with the Lutheran Church of Australia. As for the Danish congregation in Brisbane, as mentioned in Part B, in 1923, the congregation became part of the Church of Denmark Abroad. In 2004, the State Church of Denmark decided to unite their two missions in Southeast Asia and Australia, the Church of Denmark Abroad and the Danish Seamen's Church. The new mission became known as the Danish Seamen's Church and Church Abroad. Since the 1920s, the Danish Lutherans have managed to retain a foothold in Queensland. According to the webpage Danes in Australia, the Queensland Danish Lutherans still meet regularly at St. Mark's Danish Lutheran Church, Brisbane. As of the present date, the Danish Lutheran Church in Queensland is the only foreign Lutheran church in Queensland not in fellowship with the LCA, although they are members of the Lutheran World Federation, which the LCA is an associate member of. Now, speaking of the LCA, they themselves would suffer division in the early 1990s, known as the division in the LCA. The division started in 1990 with St. Mark's Lutheran Church, Hinesville, and their pastor, Melvin Grieger, which broke from the LCA over the incident known as the Open Letter Fiasco regarding the movie The Last Temptation of Christ. This split from the LCA would prompt others to follow suit. Pastor Melvin Grieger's brother, Pastor Vernon Grieger, and his congregations, Trinity Lutheran Church Marburg and St. John's Lutheran Church Minden, would also leave the LCA in 1992. And Pastor Clarence Prebino and his congregations of St. John's Lutheran Church Albini and St. Paul's Lutheran Church Oakey would also seek to leave the LCA in 1992, being joined by St. Paul's Lutheran Church Greenwood. This dissenting group, commonly called the Breakaways, faced many difficulties regarding church property. The dissenting members of Oakey would eventually have to abandon the St. Paul's Lutheran building to the LCA and instead built Trinity Lutheran Church Oakey. This group of pastors and congregations also opted to build a new confessionally Lutheran seminary, and with the help of the Chapter 1 Lutherans, a group of confessional Lutheran lay people concerned with the direction of the LCA, they purchased some land in Toowoomba to be the site of their seminary, and here they built the Bethlehem Lutheran Church Toowoomba. The division in the LCA occurred for a number of reasons, mainly concerning the increasing liberalism in the LCA. The breakaways disagreed with a number of teachings promoted by the LCA. Chief among these were the inerrancy of Scripture, the creation-evolution debate, the immortality of the soul, the role of women in the church, and the LCA's practice of responsible communion, which basically devolved into open communion. Now these seven congregations, Hydesville, Minden, Marburg, Albini, Oakey, Greenwood and Toowoomba, and their three pastors would form together to constitute the Australian Evangelical Lutheran Church, also known as the AELC, not to be confused with Audley Grieger's OELC. The AELC would be officially founded on February 14, 1993. Other concerned members of the LCA in New South Wales, Victoria and South Australia would also seek to join this newly formed synod, allowing the AELC to eventually establish small congregations in the southern states. It is here where we come across the fourth division of the ELCRA. In 1977, a group of concerned members of the LCA in Lowood split from the LCA and formed Our Redeemer Lutheran Church, Lowood, a member congregation of the ELCRA. In 1993, a majority of these members would leave the ELCRA and join the newly formed AELC. The remaining minority, which still sought to retain membership with the ELCRA, purchased some land at Chirampa and would move the congregation to this site. The newly formed AELC was not aggressively exclusive and sought fellowship amongst the other confessional Lutherans. In 1992, the St. Mark's Hydesville congregation declared fellowship with Audley Grieger's OELC. The OELC's founding pastor, Pastor Audley Grieger, was the older brother of Pastor Melvin Grieger, the pastor of Hydesville. When the AELC formed in 1993, the fellowship spread to the rest of the congregations, bringing the OELC and the AELC into fellowship. In 1999, this fellowship was severed concerning issues of the ministry and communion fellowship. In 1993, the AELC also met with representatives of the Wells and Els and the ELSA to discuss fellowship. The AELC and the ELSA were unable to achieve fellowship due to a disagreement on the office of the ministry and the doctrine of the church. The two groups were divided by the long-standing Missouri Synod, Wisconsin Synod argument over the church and ministry, the AELC taking the Missouri Synod position and the ELSA, not surprisingly, taking the Wisconsin position. The AELC and the ELSA would continue to dialogue for over a decade, finally agreeing to cease dialogue in 2010. As for these two groups, both the AELC and the ELSA would undergo their own splits. In 1999, the ELSA congregation at Kalanga, Brisbane, would secede its membership from the ELSA. However, Our Redeemer Lutheran Church Kalanga would become a member congregation of the Evangelical Lutheran Synod in the USA. And since the ELSA is in full fellowship with both the Wells and the Els, the congregation at Kalanga, while resigning membership from the ELSA, retained full fellowship with the ELSA. As for the AELC, they would suffer a major split in 2008. In late 2005, tensions arose in the AELC over the situation of lay people consecrating the Lord's Supper in the absence of a pastor. This tension came to a head in 2008, when the Synod voted to uphold the confessional Lutheran position that only a person called into the office of the ministry can consecrate the elements for Holy Communion. This would lead to a break between the AELC and those independent congregations that it was in fellowship with. In addition, pastors and congregations would also separate from the AELC. This meant that the AELC would lose all their congregations in Victoria and South Australia, and once again become a solely Queensland Lutheran Synod. As for those congregations that left the AELC, they opted to remain independent congregations instead of forming a new synod. However, these congregations all retained fellowship with one another and have operated as an unofficial synod. For this reason, I have considered these congregations as an informal synod, which I refer to as the Independents. After splitting, the Independents retained full control of the Hydesville congregation and share the buildings at Marburg and Minden with the members of the AELC. As for the congregations at Greenwood and Toowoomba, the dissenting members of the Independents would go on to build their own buildings. At the time of the split, the AELC retained congregations at Greenwood, Albini, Oakey, Toowoomba, Marburg, Minden, Lowood and Tincan Bay. Besides the division with the AELC in the early 1990s, the LCA hasn't had any other unions or divisions within Australia until the year of 2017. In 2017, Living Grace Community Lutheran Church Toowoomba opted to leave the synod. Living Grace first emerged in the year of 2000 as a church plant of the LCA's Wilsonton Glencoe Lutheran Parish. In 2002, Living Grace became its own LCA congregation. In 2008, the congregation suffered a split with members moving to the LCA's Emmanuel Lutheran congregation. Now, Living Grace was an extremely charismatic and Pentecostal Lutheran congregation, which was connected with both the Toronto Airport Church, and thus promoted the Toronto Blessing, and the New Apostolic Reformation. Living Grace and their pastor Edgar Mayer even started Lutheran Renewal, a Pentecostal organization in Australia dedicated to spreading the New Apostolic Reformation across the country. After conflicts arose in 2017, Living Grace decided to leave the synod. Living Grace was given a peaceful dismissal from the LCA on August 27th, 2017. But while the Living Grace congregation sought to retain their Lutheran teaching, they have dropped the name Lutheran, lest they appear unwelcoming to the surrounding community, and instead simply call themselves Living Grace Church Toowoomba. This now brings us up to the present day, and thus we end our brief history of Lutheranism in Queensland. Thus, at the present time of 2017, the state of Lutheranism in Queensland is as followed. We have 5 separate Lutheran synods, the largest being the Lutheran Church of Australia. The second biggest is the Australian Evangelical Lutheran Church. The third largest is the Evangelical Lutheran Congregations of the Reformation. The fourth is the Evangelical Lutheran Synod of Australia. And the fifth is the Orthodox Evangelical Lutheran Church. After this, we have the Independent Lutheran Congregations located at Hydesville, Greenwood, Toowoomba, Marburg and Minden. These are the former members of the AELC, which make up our informal synod. After that, we have the Independent Congregation, Our Redeemer Lutheran Congregation at Kalanga, which is a member of the Evangelical Lutheran Synod in America and is in fellowship with the Evangelical Lutheran Synod of Australia. After that, we also have the Living Grace Church Toowoomba. And as for non-English-speaking Lutherans in Australia, we have the Queensland Latvian Evangelical Lutheran Congregation, which is a member of the Latvian Evangelical Lutheran Church abroad and is in fellowship with the Lutheran Church of Australia. We also have St. Mark's Danish Lutheran Church Brisbane, a member of the Danish Seamen's Church and Church abroad. This ends our brief history on Lutheranism in Queensland. As we approach the 500th anniversary of the Lutheran Reformation, we also come to the 200-year anniversary of the Prussian Union of Churches. The King of Prussia sought to unite the Lutherans and the Reformed together, but instead he caused the Lutheran Church to splinter rapidly. In 2018, Lutherans will have been in Queensland, and also henceforth Australia, for a total of 180 years. They started out as only a handful of Lutheran missionaries, and now Lutheranism in Queensland is divided into 5 separate synods and a handful of independent congregations. As for the future of Lutheranism in Queensland, will we see further division or further unity? Only time will tell.